Oh God. Oh God. Trailer's on fire. Well, we don't need no water. Let the motherfucker burn. Oh, Jesus. Oh, baby. A little squirt. Whoa! We'll get heating up. Oh, God! It's gonna burn good now. Make sure we get the top side. She sits outside. It's cold out, it's 38. Gotta make sure the paint sticks. Jelly beans. Get the fire in there nice and good. Oh, Jesus! Alright, that should be plenty warm enough. Chill. Burn the whole thing down. Oh, yeah. All new term to bake and paint. Oh yeah, look at that. Doesn't that look nice? Oh yeah. There's some big shit right here, boys and girls. We have exceeded the GVWR of this here Ford. But it still works. Alright, we're gonna knock the toolbox and the winch. Okay, so a little bit has happened since I last saw you. Phone was getting ready to die. I did cut these pieces. I get the focus. They are 5 feet tall. They are 3 foot across. Inside ID. The plan is we're gonna stitch weld these onto the trailer, and then we're gonna make a little L bracket to hold the toolbox. And then we gotta figure out the winch. I don't know if I'm gonna mount the winch in the toolbox or on here and build a cover. I'm not sure yet. But, yeah, anyways, let's keep going. All right, so we got the toolbox mounted. We'll clean that out. Winch is mounted, welded. It's like you're strong. That's probably it for today. I'll catch you back on another day when we use it. Okay, welcome back to another video. Actually, it's the same video. It's in continuance of working on the trailer, putting the toolbox and the winch on there. So today we're gonna try and get the 50 on the trailer by myself. We gotta move all Blue. Where are you, Blue? Hey, Blue. Gotta move Blue. Gotta move the Lincoln. And then the, I can't do this, S10, push the door, move a bunch of shit. So, yeah, we're gonna try and get the 52 out. 1950 F2. So the 50 steers, I think. So I think I'm gonna back the trailer in at an angle and try and pull it out of that spot. Should be enough room there. And I'll use the winch to pull it the rest of the way on there. Say hi, Carrie.
Hi, Carrie.
That's what I heard.
Well, Ryan kind of talked to me about it.
Why not the keg?
That way I don't drop fuel pressure and detonate the motor.
Oh, look at all that CM electric power.
Chevy 350 small block, which if you don't know, it's for sale, $700, 17 owners, right. Low miles, only bounced off the one step, what, 12 times?
12, 13 times, yeah.
One step, yep. Let's hear it rip. Scary. So we got the F2 on the trailer. Definitely need a stronger battery. Let's see, I want to put power cables from the front of the truck to the back bumper so I can like plug in the winch directly, like 2-gauge, 0-gauge cables. They sell kits, I might do that next. So we'll drop that off at work tomorrow. And then maybe I'll take the tripod. I'll film that too. Because I took the tractor there today with the fork so we can use it to lift the back off because that right rear tire is locked up. But hopefully I can do that by myself with the tractor. So drive that to work tomorrow. And then tomorrow, if I got time, we'll come get the S10. We'll put that on the trailer. Same thing after work. We'll drop that off. And then after that, I might build a shelf or something. Put the international cab on and then the fenders and all that stuff. So anyways, I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, today's the next day, a few days later. We're gonna work on getting the S10 onto the trailer by myself. I think we'll get it done. So let's get going. Alright, so the trailer mods were a success. I really like the winch. I really need to get a power cable where it runs off the truck battery. Get that put on. Or get the solar charger set up. I think I'm done with this video. It's probably been long enough. But I'm gonna put a full-size car battery where that breakaway battery is. And hopefully the truck, when you plug it in the 7-pin, it'll charge it, so. But, alright, thanks for watching. There'll be more videos. Subscribe if you want to see the rest of them, so. This is Fixer Fab.